players who were involved in the Luton game are also available for the game tomorrow. Then with the injuries, it's always the same. First step is to be available back for training. Second step is then to be available back for the games, and the third step is then also to be really full in this rhythm and game fit. So can confirm that Teemu Pukki is back in training, and because he was not out too long, then if nothing happens, so we have another training session, if there is no setback, then he will be also available for the game tomorrow and will be with us. Also the recovery of Jordan Hugill and Todd Cantwell and all the others is quite well, I have to say. So the plan is, if there is no further setback, that probably on Sunday or on Monday they will be able to train also back with the team. So Jordan Hugill, also Todd Cantwell, and perhaps also already Kieran Dowell. So some good news. And then we have to wait a little bit how quick they are then also available for the games, and then also to be ready to make an impact. But definitely some good news in terms of the recovery. Yeah, it's the first steps back to normality, and it's definitely great. So we were already there with one pilot project when 1,000 fans were allowed, and this worked quite well also for us in terms of safety and also with the mood and the atmosphere and the spirit in the stadium. And of course it's great to have at least 2,000 back. So of course we're all looking forward to have situations when the stadiums are full again, because I mentioned several times that football is a game for human beings, and the supporters should be there. But I think in this strange times during this pandemic, also good encouraging signs and the first steps back to normality. And of course, great to have them back. No comments from this side. I had to speak 3 months about transfer speculations and rumors. And right now, thank God, we have a period where the transfer window is closed. Anyhow, so I will speak. I know this already. From the 1st of January to the 31st of January, each and every day. And we'll be asking each and every day about who can come in, who may leave, or something like this. So I'm not tempted during this quiet period to speculate and comment any rumors. So for that, nothing from myself to this point. Yeah, first of all, I'm really looking forward to meet Tony again, because it's always a pleasure to meet him. He's there with so much experience and so much knowledge about the game, so much knowledge about football. It's always a pleasure to have a chat with him, and he behaves himself really with dignity and pride, and it's always great to have a chat with him. So he's such a educated person, and the fire is still burning. Yeah? You can see this at the touchline. This also for sure. So it's always unbelievably difficult to play against his sides and to break Tony Pulis' side. So he knows exactly what is important in order to stay absolutely solid, to be absolutely compact. And also no coincidence that since he overtook, I think they have a goal, conceded goal average from under one. So they either finish with one goal. I think one goal is the highest amount of goals that they have conceded on the last game. They played against a really good side for really high amount of a big amount of minutes in underload, and they were able to manage to get a point. So this says a lot about the experience and the class that Tony has, but not only in terms of football knowledge, also how he behaves as a person. And it's always a pleasure to meet him, and I'm looking forward to do this. It's always difficult then to find a way to beat one of his teams. So for that, it will be a complicated task, but we are also there with confidence. We try to find a way, and then it's also definitely good to have a chat with them after the game. Yes, there's no doubt it will influence also your signing decisions and also how you act on the transfer market. So to be honest, our first view was always on the homegrown market, because it's the easiest way and the easiest choice. Yeah, but sometimes also the most expensive choice. So meanwhile, we're in a much better situation. I think we can afford right now also to go a bit more aggressive on this homegrown market. But one of our strategies will always be to be pretty much aware what happens abroad. So the new rules are, I would label them quite complicated, and also opens a bit, for example, a bit more, because of the rules, the South American market in comparison to some other countries in Europe. So you'll have also to change a bit your concentration of your scouting, how you want to scout. But on the other hand, it's also we improve, and hopefully step by step as a club. And anyhow, then we also don't have to have a deeper look, more like in the second and the third tire of some countries. No, we can also go for the first tire. So because we improve in our level of quality that we can sign, and also hopefully also in terms of the money that we can spend. So the more successful we are as a club, the easier it is also to adapt to this new rules. But it definitely has an impact, and we have to be smart also in our decisions on which countries we will concentrate from now on. That's also no doubt. Yes.